Yo, what's good everyone? This is BGFX here, and this is going to be a breakdown video. I'm going to get into a trade that I took on EURUSD. It was some sells that I took. I'm going to go into my thought process. I'm going to break down the entire outlook behind what led me to taking sells. You know, so it was like a series of events that happened within the markets that actually allowed me to take my entry. So I'm not like a long-term trader. I can look at what's happening recently and I can kind of formulate a bias through everything that the markets are telling me. But when you're getting on the charts, you want to be creating some type of story for yourself. So I'm actually just going to go back. I'm going to put the replay tool on so you can see exactly what I was seeing as I got on the charts. So you can see like right here, 7 a.m. This is when I was getting to the charts. And I'm basically just looking at everything that's happened recently. So I can see that we had Asia's range, which is marked off with this box. Asia's low was swept. Asia's high was also swept. And then we began to mitigate off of it. So I'm going to take that Asia range off for now. And you can see that we have this zone right here on EU. Now, I use the 15-minute for my zones. For my intraday areas, I pretty much only use the 15 minute. I found that to be a good overall time frame to find my zones on. So this was my 15 minute zone that I had charted out the next day. And then as we began to like trade back into it and draw back into the zone, we were potentially coming up for the mitigation. Now there's multiple ways that the market likes to do things. But depending on what you trade, you most likely have that similar belief system of either supply and demand or those type of things. There's always going to be price reacting to supply and demand. Supply and demand is what drives the markets. Buyers and sellers, either buyers are stronger or sellers are stronger. If there's no type of dominance within either of those, then you're going to have a consolidated market. But since there's always going to be either a dominance of buyers and sellers, and that's what makes the market go around, you have to understand that there's different ways in which price is going to engineer these zones to actually work. So we can see that the zone was, of course, created here, right? My 15-minute zone. Basically, I'm looking for aggression. I'm looking for fast price action out of the zone. Even some inducements, right? Even some short-term structure points. So like this little high right here can be swept. This little high right here can be swept. And this can be like liquidity to be taken, so that price can come up and mitigate an area. So we have a good zone. This is pretty much all the way at the top of the range. The higher up near the range a zone is, usually the stronger it can be. Of course, it depends on a few different things, but we can see, right, that this zone was kind of flowing through with some bearish momentum of price. So if we look at what happened on Tuesday, you see that price mitigates here, drops off, mitigates here, drops off, mitigates here, drops off. You know, buyers attempt to hold some weight from this zone down here, mitigates here, drops off. And then now I'm just looking for the next mitigation. You know, so now I want to look at the details. After I understand what all of this has done, of course, it's kind of clear that sellers do have some momentum within this. So now I'm asking myself, you know, what are the details telling me, and are sellers possibly gaining further momentum? So I'm going to bring it back. And I only trade New York sessions. So when I'm getting on the charts in New York, I'm also asking myself, you know, what has happened through London and Asia that could potentially set me up for a trade? So just like I'm looking at these little structure points as possible inducements for the mitigation. And since Asia's high here did fail to touch my zone, I can put the indicator back on. You can see that now I can build a bias that potentially, if we do sweep this high, sells can be offered. And also it is in alignment with what has been happening recently. Now, of course, if we look below Asia's low, you always want to be viewing the market from two different spectrums, right? Because there's going to be people that have bullish perspectives and there's going to be people that have bearish perspectives. And one of them is always going to be right eventually. So you're going to ask yourself, you know, how can I logically put myself in a direction of who is going to be in control within the markets? So at this point, of course, we started trading up, and I wasn't on the charts, but this is like 3 a.m. So you can see that we trade up into here and then we begin to react off. So this shows that sellers did hold weight. And just like I was saying about this zone right here, I like to see zones created with aggression. You can see that after we swept this high, we immediately came out with aggression. So that's showing basically that sellers do have some strength from this area. And if they do hold strength from this area, I can then refine and look to further find ways to get into price. So you can see right here, it's 5 a.m. Once again, I'm not on the charts at this time. And then finally, we have this. Right, so I see that we've reacted to this zone, which is basically in alignment with everything else that's happened. And then I can see that we have like a minor little break in structure right here. A minor break of structure. So after we have that break of structure here, you can see that we have this zone on the 15 minute that was created. Now at this point, once I see that this zone's created, I could check the time, 6:45. I'm on the charts at this point, right? So 7 o'clock, I'm on the charts. I see that we have a fresh zone here. And I see that basically everything has lined up. So what I do is I'm gonna be looking at my other time frames. I'm gonna go down to the 10 minute and I could see that I could even refine this a little bit more into here. And then at this point, I could even look left and I see that we have this zone here, this range. So this high into this low, mitigation, break of structure, and then we have another zone right here that we potentially can mitigate and then trade out of. But of course, it's all going to depend who is in control within the markets. So for me, the way I'm going to go ahead and get involved in this is I'm going to look for the lower time frame to tell me some type of story. Sometimes if a direction is clear enough to me, I'll take a high time frame entry. I'll take like a 15 minute entry without really needing any type of 1 minute confirmation. But it's all going to depend on what the markets are showing. You know, for this exact scenario, I wanted to find a reason to get in on a 1 minute just because of how bullish price has been. You can see that EU has been very bullish recently. And I now want to see if it makes sense to align myself with sales. And what I'm noticing is that we are basically reacting to the range and everything is looking good within it. You know, of course, we're reacting to this little bullish zone as well, but there's always going to be an exchange of buyers and sellers, like I said. So you got to ask yourself, does your perspective make sense? You know, does it make sense to accept the risk that comes with your trade? Because as much as we want to like believe that something needs to happen or a zone is super clean, you also got to understand risk comes with it. So you have to be building a story and building a narrative to where you accept the risk that comes with it. You know, a lot of traders nowadays don't even see the risk in with it, don't even see the risk within their trading. Like they take their entries and they'll think like, okay, I either win this trade or I'm doing something wrong. And that's not always true. You can lose a trade and still do everything right. That's just the risk that comes with trading. And that's why it goes back to us being in like a probability game. Everything about trading is probability. So you need to be able to hold your winners. You need to be able to follow a plan, abide by that plan, you know, find the strengths within your plan, and then basically take advantage of it. So we have a breaking structure here, and then we have the zone. So at this point, what I'm doing is I'm now monitoring on the 1 minute, and I also want to kind of take a look at what's being offered on the 1 minute. So of course, we have this range created, which is that up move followed by aggressive down move. These ranges are what deliver price. Some people call them BFI ranges. Some people call them, of course, a basic supply area. Some people call it an order block. Whatever you want to call it, man, it's up to you. But it is a good way of approaching the market. So we have the up, the aggression. You can see that right there, it's during London. So 3:30 a.m., boom, we get the aggressive up move. But just as aggressive as we move up, we move right back out of it with aggression. And then, so that's going to be that range created. This is that visible 15-minute zone. And then, of course, little internal structure points get swept, and then we come out with aggression again. So now I'm going to be looking, and I'm going to try to see how I can get involved with this zone here that I just charted out on the 10-minute. So you can see on the 10-minute, this is visible. And then what I did was I refined my area. And I also marked out this wick up top. So this is a zone within a zone. Very simple way to refine. And then you can see we begin to trade up. We begin to react off of the refined area right here, as you can see. And then I draw another zone here. I'm now looking at the edge of this range. So we have the up followed by the aggression. And I basically repeated the entire process multiple times over. So I see my higher time frame range, I see reaction out of that higher time frame range, and then we have another range, and then I finally take the refined trade. Now you might be asking, you know, if you're just repeating, why didn't you get in here and here and basically have these as confirmations of this zone here? And the reason is because I wasn't on the charts at that time. So I'm getting in during New York and I'm kind of lining that entire story up of a bearish order flow, you know? So at that point, I see that we're moving out with aggression. I always want to see aggression from my zones. And then we begin to trade back up. And then there we go. So we missed the zone. You could see that my zone was here. We kind of trade off of it. I noticed that in a moment. And just like the same exact thing happened on the higher time frame where we missed my zone here. And then we come up and we mitigate. It's basically going to be the same approach. So we miss my zone. And then what I want to see is price to kind of create a little short-term structural high, which is what happened, and then come up, mitigate, and hopefully move out with aggression. As we move out with aggression, move my stop loss down into the entry, and then basically have a risk-free trade, and I can hold it to my targets. So as you can see, we begin to react off of it, make that low, and then we have a little bit of strength coming in right here from this zone. So this little sell and the buy mitigation, and then that can sweep that high to mitigate the edge of this, and then we'd be looking for that reaction. So let's see how everything goes. There we go, swept the high. And what I actually did is I entered right on the candle close. So right as we wicked off, the candle closed and I went ahead, boom, I took my sells, stop loss with 4 pips, take profit was down here for 22 pips. Now my entry should have been here, and that would have actually gave me a much better risk to reward, but I kind of missed it in the moment. So I entered literally just a few seconds later after we reacted off, and then I was able to get in and have my stop loss set, my take profit set. And then you can see we begin to react out of it with aggression. Like I said, when I'm looking at the markets, I really don't like to see price play around too much at my zones. It's okay to have like internal structure. So like this little boxed off area, yes, it's ranging, yes, it's consolidating, yes, it's creating lows, but it's happening internally around my zone. So those could be like sweeps to touch my zones. But when it comes to like my actual zones, if it starts doing this, that's not really stuff I like to see. I like to see everything happen quick, because the best moves in the market always happen fast. You'll notice that the market, when it wants to be bearish, it's going to move bearish with intentions. When it wants to be bullish, it's going to be bullish with intentions. You know, it's not really going to waste any time. So I don't like to be in trades that consolidate too much. I always want to be, I want to notice the consolidation at the time when I'm not in the markets. And then as we sweep some consolidation to kind of formulate my bias, I get in with the intention move, the move that has intention behind it, should I say. So there we go. Move down very aggressively. Now we have this little zone right here that, of course, we could definitely react off of, but I didn't really see any reason to try and take any partials here just because of all this right here. A lot of rangy price action. I really didn't see price having a high probability of reacting off of it. I definitely see more of a probability that we would sweep that low to mitigate down here at the extreme, or to come over here and touch like this little this demand zone that came up. So price moves from zone to zone. Everything else for me is just like intentions and confirmation and reasons to target certain areas. So you can see that we react off. And then range a little bit. We do get a little reaction from it, which isn't too surprising. And then we miss the entry, then we come back down. Or we miss the TP, we come back up, then boom, we come right back down. And then after that, you can see that we just continue to trade. We continue to trade off more and more bearish. So overall, sellers did really show the dominance this day. So I'm just gonna press play, let it do its thing. But you can see, man, just the way the markets deliver, It's literally from mitigation to mitigation. So for me, everything is about finding a good quality location, building a good narrative within my trade, and just allowing myself to take good quality setups only. Because at the end of the day, like, as traders, it's up to us. You know, no one else is making decisions for us. We're able to kind of look at everything to our better judgment and then just take the best possibility or the best probability trades that we can. So, like, if you can take one trade like this, you know, you can literally take 100 more trades like this. It's just, do you have the skill set to know when these type of trades here present themselves? Because you might take a trade like this, and next day you might, you know, get to the charts and you see something that doesn't really look good, but then you don't want to miss out on another potentially good trade, so you might rush it, and then that can easily cause a loss. So one of the most interesting things about trading is the amount of work that you have to put into decision making and really just keeping a high level of focus on just thinking logically, because it's so easy to literally take like a random trade on a certain day, and in the moment, you know, you'll have that mindset that, okay, this is a potential 1 to 10, I don't want to miss it, I'm going to take it. And then after the trade, you'll look at that trade and you'll be like, you know, I don't know why I took it. You know, looking back, it doesn't really make sense. So it's just all about finding that balance, and it's something that comes with time. But this overall was a pretty solid setup. Let's just say you took this on like a prop firm account, which is what I did. I took this on my 100K funded account. This was a 1 to 5, but I made a little bit more than a 6K. So this right here, I risk a little bit more than 1% on the prop firm account. And that's enough, 5,000-6,000 just on one trade. You know, you can take a couple of those trades a month, and, you know, you'll have a great foundation within your journey, and you could basically do this full time. But the question is, you know, do you have the patience and do you have the skill set to select those two good quality trades every month? Because it goes deep, you know, the skill set goes deep. You know, you can always get better. You can always understand how to minimize, you know, preventable losses and things like that. So it's just a never-ending journey of working on your skill set, getting better, and things like that. So this was overall solid trade. Only trade I took this week, but that's pretty much it, everyone. I hope y'all got some value from this video. If you did, as usual, hit the like, hit the subscribe button. And if you got any questions, if you enjoyed the video, let me know in the comments. Let me know what else you want to see. But it's been BGFX. I hope you guys all have a great day. And I'll see y'all in the next one.